consider this your first class in Wudang Bakwa. As a martial arts, what you're trying to do, you try to get behind your opponent. When you try to get behind your opponent, you can attack them from the back. That's the whole point. It's mean, but it's the reality of Bakwa. We are on our way to our classroom. Our classroom is an outside platform which is built for who knows what kind of reason. And this platform has only one major use, because nobody ever there. And the use is very simply to be used as our classroom. You see, the area here is very beautiful, it's natural, it's very much middle class residential area, but there are some things in the design which fit in perfectly with the Wudang culture. Here, this is a lane. Feng shui wise, this is great, and this is our platform. This area is a palace area. And this is where we do our class. Okay, the first part is when you're walking, you're looking past your hands. So your hand posture is very important. Your upper palm, the line from here goes to here. So this is one direct line. The thumb and the pink, they are grabbing. If they would touch somebody's face, this would touch on the forehead, this one would touch on the chin, and this one would touch on the chin too. So you try to push somebody away with that palm. When you're looking past the hand, this way, in this direction. So you're all the time looking at the hand. As a martial arts, what you're trying to do, you try to get behind your opponent. When you try to get behind your opponent, you can attack them from the back. That's the whole point. It's mean, but it's the reality of Bakwa. And at the moment when you walk, both hands are pressing. This is your standard walk. This is what you're going to start with. Altogether, there are 8 different walks. And these 8 different walks, they form the foundation of the major exercise of Bakwa. And that's it. I gave you a little bit of an idea about what the class will look like. Every class will have, you know, something about exercise, a little bit of theory to explain to you what you're going to do, and it will offer you a gradual progression through the exercises until you have done the whole Bakwa series. I am not sure how long time we need, because it is something that I do for the first time in this way. Every recording will be between 5 and 10 minutes. I try to do everything outside, but at a certain point when it's raining, already my excuses, I'm not going to practice in the rain for you. Of course, after seeing this, you see that I will pay attention to a lot of detail. I tell you a lot of details that you would like to know, not necessarily what Kung Fu schools usually teach you. This is my style. I always like to give a lot of detail to make sure that you know what it is about, and I try to keep it real. I try not to mystify things. I try to keep things simple and practical, and that's basically how it is. In fact, that is basically how complicated things already get without mystifying things. Okay, I go.